channel. So today I'm going to be doing the perfect palette tag. I was tagged with my friend Connie here on YouTube, so I'm gonna go ahead and start because I feel like I'm gonna talk a lot in this video because when it comes to talking about products, especially like palettes, I am a blabber. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with the first question. So I have it here on my iPad. First question is best packaging. So best packaging for me will have to be hands down Too Faced Cosmetics, preferably the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. This is the new one that Too Faced did come out with, and I love their packaging for their peanut butter palette, for the Bon Bon palette, for the Too Faced Semi Sweet palette, chocolate bar palette. They are all amazing. They all come in this tin, which is awesome because for the most part your product is safe. Except for the one that I got. I recently got the Semi Sweet palette and it like opened and shattered. I got it from HSN and I'm so disappointed, but I still kept it. But other than that, they are pretty safe, travel friendly as well. So I really like the packaging for this one in particular. Next question, best color payoff. For the best color payoff, it has to be hands down Natasha Denona. This is the Natasha Denona, I think, warm eye palette or something like that. Or what is this? I don't remember the name. But this is how it looks like. They are so pigmented. This is a pretty pricey palette, but they are super pigmented, blendable. They have a variety of mattes, metallics, satins. So beautiful. And again, Natasha Denona is hitting the freaking makeup game strong. It doesn't say what palette this is on the packaging, but this is like the warm, I think like the brown blue palette, I think. But this is the Natasha Denona palette, and this palette has amazing color payoff. To me, the one that is best for traveling, which is the third question, is the Too Faced Stardust palette. I've taken this with me everywhere. Every time I go home, I bring this palette. When I go traveling, I bring this palette. This is an amazing palette just because it has your shades that you know you're going to be using, like the transitional shades up here, the bolds, the transitionals, the no not transitionals, the neutrals, I mean, purple, pops of color. It has everything you need in this palette. This palette was limited edition. I'm so sad that this wasn't a permanent palette in Too Faced collection. But if you do have this, this is amazing for traveling. It's very, very thin, which fits nicely into your makeup bag or to your travel bag. And it's just a very nice palette. Very pigmented, as always. Too Faced never goes wrong with their pigmentation, with their eyeshadows. But there are some that I don't like, which I will bring up in this video. But for right now, this is a really nice one for traveling. Now, for biggest regrets, I do have this in an upcoming video. I will go more into detail with this palette, but I regret this one. This is by Stila, and yeah, this is their holiday collection palette. I don't like it. Biggest regret, literally, is so huge. This doesn't fit anywhere in my vanity. Also, these two palettes from Too Faced, this is the Rock and Roll palette and the Too Faced Sugar Pop palette. I don't use these. That's the reason why they are my regrets video. And I think this goes into the number six question, which is the least used. I don't know, I'm jumping around everywhere. This is the least used. I don't know, I just don't think these colors are my jam. I just got it because of the packaging and it was pretty cheap at Nordstrom Rack. And I don't know, I just don't like it. Like, maybe I'll use them during the springtime, which is now. But for the most part, I didn't use these, which kind of sucks because these are really good palettes, I think, and should be used for the most part, but I don't use these. So scratch out number six. These are the least used and also one of my biggest regrets. For the best color names, it always goes back to Too Faced Cosmetics. This is not a sponsored video, by the way, from Too Faced. I wish, but it's not. The peanut butter palette is so cute packaging wise as well, but the names are so cute. Ooh, just close on me. This is Soft and Sweet, Rich and Creamy, PB&J, Banana, Spread the Love, Extra Creamy, Peanut Butter, Peanut Butter Cup, Peanut Brittle, Jammin', Jelly, Nuts About You. All these names are so cute. I know the other ones have cute names as well, but the ones in this one, I don't know, just like, oh, it's so cute. And it's so tiny. It just looks so, it looks so cute and the names are so cute. So I think the peanut butter palette has the cute names. So the last question is the most used, which is the Stardust palette. The most loved, which is the semi-sweet, not semi-sweet palette, the sweet peach palette. And the one that I would take if I was stuck in a desert will be the Morphe 350. And the reason why I picked this one is because all of these are neutrals. And you guys know I love me some neutrals. So this is how the palette looks like. I know I did an accent right now. I don't know why I did that. This is how the palette looks like. And it's just all neutrals. It has the browns, the oranges, the sparkly pinks, the sparkly golds. It's just a very nice palette. And if I was stuck in a desert, I would take the Morphe 350. And that is it for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this palette tag. And if you guys have any other questions or comments, leave them down below in the comment section below. And also, thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.